everybody birthdays for real. Go give us a high five, everybody, and say bye.
Make a cruise experience in one piece. You got the very best guide.
Alicia.
And the greatest driver.
Charlie.
You're the best. I love it. Even though
Alicia
owes me $5. I know you guys are excited to get on the tour, but first,
this is all the bandmates come to work every day. Like Kristen Bell, Blake Shelton, Steve Harvey, all come to work here every single day. But see, the rich legacy of this lot started back in 1914 by Mr. Carl Lindley, and that still continues to this day. Started with a lot of the great classics, but it's led up to a lot of the big blockbusters that you see. If you look on either side of this tram, the city you see because of what you see on your right-hand side. No, that is not a set. That is a real working fire station. We have our own fire station, our own medical service, our own sheriff's office, and even our very own zip code. Yes, you're really inside. It is Soundstage 12, which is currently home for NBC's singing competition, The Voice, which the doors are actually open to take a sneak peek inside to your left and see what the inside of a soundstage looks like. But yes, that is where they have coaches Blake Shelton, Adam Levine, Kelly Clarkson, and Jennifer Hudson. And it's hosted by Carson Daly. But Soundstage 12 is one of our biggest soundstages, being over 29,000. Other productions, they can play to the sound because we have great control over the sound and lighting in production, which is why we have so many sound stages. To your left, you'll see sound stages 20 through 16. Sound stage G sound light there on your left hand side. That's more of an extension to the store. But if you cross the street, you'll see sound stage 29. Now, sound stage 29 is the new home to Family Steve Harvey Show. Right here is at a sound stage 41 to your right hand side. But now they have sitcoms that allow you to go in and be audience members. For instance, at Marlin, you can get free tickets to be audience members. But speaking of sitcoms, as the Steve Harvey Show, we've had quite a few of our newer sitcoms is Marlin with Marlon Wayans, like Doris Day, Rock Hudson, Jimmy Stewart, Lucille Ball, Eddie Murphy, and Tom Cruise. All used to have dressing rooms here. But now these are production offices for some great writers, directors, and they have offices here in our bungalows. Also, Brownstone Productions, they brought us Pitch Perfect and Pitch Perfect 2, also housed here. But Soundstage 22 and 23, these have been dedicated as the Will and Grace Soundstage for the award-winning show, starring Eric McCormick, Deborah Messing, Megan Mullally, and Sean Hayes. But that's not the only production that they place here. For instance, this is where America's Got Talent with Simon Cowell and Mel B have filmed. And also, World of Dance with executive producer Jennifer Lopez. She's also a judge of the show, along with Derek Huff.
Close the door! Okay. I'm in the shower!
Inside bad, outside good. Inside bad, outside good. Out.
Oh, you're done now. Great.
Beautiful. Yes, that is how you spell beautiful. But another thing that's very beautiful about this area is that this is where Michael Jackson filmed scenes from his Moonwalker music video. And if you look to your left, you'll see the steps that you just seen in the clip, but you'll also know that this was the area that they utilized in Home Alone 2 Lost in New York. But speaking of New York, we're actually going to head on to our New York streets. Yes, this is where a lot of productions take place. This is where American Ninja Warrior was filmed. Yeah, they had all of their obstacle course set up right here on our lots. It's currently being utilized for a production. It's set up as a nice city here. But I'm going to let my friend Jimmy say a little bit more about New York, because after all, that is where he filmed The Tonight Show.
Hey, everyone. Welcome to New York. I got my start right here in New York on Saturday Night Live. This is actually my old neighborhood. What's got mugged over there? An old woman. Tough lady. This is my favorite hot dog guy. Hey, buddy. How's it going? Remember me?
No.
Just like old times. Gotta love New York City.
Hey, I'm walking here.
It's cool, guys. I was just, you know.
Directors like Alfred Hitchcock, Steven Spielberg, and Mr. Peter Jackson.
It's the original King Kong that will sweep you up in the ninja. Kong literally does it. I mean, you're on board the ship, you're sailing to a lost island, you're encountering monsters and creatures from, you know, prehistoric times. So I was thrilled when Universal invited me back to Skull Island, and it's great to have you along for the ride. Now, we have created this 3D immersive experience, so you're going to have your glasses ready. Don't put them on yet, but just have them in your hand because we're about to return. Just... In a sense, this is like a mini sequel, a mini continuation. Here you have to take into account that people are looking in all directions.
We have our selection from the Back to the Future films. That is this car with 100% less cow manure. We have Fred and Barney's car from the Flintstones. Those are golf carts with shells over them.
Back
and
what
we've got our cars from the Fast and Furious franchise. And we even have the Jeep Wrangler from Jurassic World, in which Jurassic World Fallen Kingdom just came out last weekend. But we even have some from my personal favorites. We have some from Transformers. But I want to tell you something about that fighter vehicle. That fighter vehicle looks pretty strong, right? Will you really stand its time in a war? Well, no, it cannot. Simply because that is made of nothing but plywood. Yeah, it's just plywood. Makes it a lot easier to move. On either side of the tram, you'll see some of the actual set and prop pieces from the Jurassic Park films. Here on the left, you'll see the mobile lab unit that was utilized in the Lost World of Jurassic Park. Now, we like to keep our dinosaurs close because you never know when we're doing the production. But don't worry, they're in their cages. Oh no, they're not in the cages. Look out! I am so sorry. I forgot to mention to you all that if you were sitting in a blue seat that you may get wet. Yeah, just kidding. You're all in a blue seat except for me and Julie. That's why we're still dry. But doesn't it seem like every time the dinosaur appeared on the screen that there was always some type of extreme weather condition involved? Well, that's because weather plays a huge role in setting just the right mood needed for our production. And here in California, we don't get rain that often. So usually when we need a change of weather for our production, we gotta create it. And we're gonna show you how we do that as we're headed right here into Old Mexico. Now I wanna remind everyone to please remain seated. Be sure to hold on to all your friends. Now that thunder is brought to us by speakers that's hidden within the set. The lightning is by strobe lights at the top. But then usually what follows thunder and lightning? Yes, the rain. These raindrops may seem a little bit bigger than what you're used to simply because they want to make sure that they appear on camera. Back in the black and white film, and it's a technique that's still used today, they would add powder and water together to be sure to capture the rain on camera. It's only raining in certain areas because that's when the camera will sit to capture the rain needed for the scene. Oh no, I hear it. Look out, it's a flashbulb. Look out for a green force. Oh no, it's coming this way. Look out. Also filmed right there in Old Mexico. But for now, I'm going to cross out of Old Mexico and head into the Old West. This is where we film a lot of our Westerns, and a lot of Western stars have mosey on through these streets, like Clint Eastwood. It's currently being utilized for our production. But just note that these are some of our oldest sets utilized here on our lot. But these are known for a lot of barroom brawls.
First. Mine was taller.
Foster, our death.
Cool.
This location, the afterlife, come on. I have never, ever seen this. You're in the good place.
I'm not supposed to be here. I can't risk going to the bad place.
Okay, well, maybe it's not all that bad.
How can I help you?
What is the bad place like?
Well, it doesn't sound awesome.
Yes, this is where the good place filmed a lot of their exterior scenes. You may see there in the area, that is where they filmed the pilot episode. That was where they did the orientation. But yes, you'll see a lot of the set pieces are still up. They were just filming out here for their third season. But also filmed here in Little Europe was The Princess Diaries 2, A Royal Engagement with Anne Hathaway. And also Roger and Hammerstein's Cinderella with Whitney Houston and Brandy was also filmed right here in Little Europe. But Little Europe is known to be the birth of the horror film, simply because there have been quite a few horror films that have been shot right here on our lot, specifically to your right-hand side in the area we like to call Court of Miracles. There have been horror films like Dracula, Frankenstein, Bride of Frankenstein, The Hunchback of Notre Dame, The Mummy, yes, all filmed here in Court of Miracles. If you look to your left, you'll see we're passing some prop pieces, and then we're going to pass by a nice backyard, and then you'll see the gray house with the red roof. This is utilized for Hallmark's Home and Family. That show is a talk show that gets you DIY, so you may see a lot of cooking segments done there, but something really cool to know is they have a very quick turnaround process. So whatever you may see being filmed on Monday will be put on your TV screens on Tuesday.